Welcome to Fire to Inspire. I'm your host, Angel Yasmin. You are listening to Next 411 on IBNXradio.com. Our goal is to inspire you to ignite your passion and purpose. We will direct you for greater happiness, love, relationships, health, and fulfillment. Let's focus on your superpowers, values, core beliefs, and help determine what's important for your next chapter in life. All right, it's getting real hot up in here. Let's fire away. Welcome back, Atlanta. I'm your host, Angel Yasmin, and thank you for tuning in on Fire to Inspire each Thursday from 1 to 2 p.m. on Next 411 on IBNXradio.com. Today, we have a very special guest by the name of Sarah Busby. What's up, boo?
Girl, what's up? What's up?
Girl, I'm so excited to have you on the show right now.
I'm excited to be here.
Because we have had some heavy topics the last couple of weeks. Yeah. And so I wanted to bring some sunshine on this radio show this week because we have a huge networking party coming up on Sunday.
It's a party. I like that. It's a party, definitely.
So tell us a little bit more about what's going on Sunday. Tell us
all about it. Okay, so Be The Buzz PR, my company, we are having the Mix and Buzz Fall Social Experience. And when I say experience, it is definitely an experience. So when you walk in, you're going to feel like, okay, like I see, okay, this is an experience of the moment you take in, right? It's a moment that you cherish, a moment that you can like go back to. So it's an event where we're going to have actually some networking, but not just your traditional nowadays. I just walk into a room and I kind of just stand around, you know, looking maybe awkwardly. We're going to make sure that you are actually networking and going to that actual, maybe that person or maybe that unexpected person that you're not even looking for. We're going to have games, mic drops of your business so you can have the opportunity to talk about your business for a minute.
Yes,
you know, all of
good.
That. Be in the room of just potential business partners and collaborations for 2020. It's right around the corner.
Gotta
get it right.
Love it. I cannot wait. And I am the host. Hello.
Yes.
What's up? We gonna be so turned up. What? Y'all have got to, you've got to get on board. If you have not gotten your tickets, we're gonna talk about how you can get your tickets at the end. But look, Sarah is not, she's not a stranger to Fire to Inspire. This is her second time being on the show.
Yes.
Well, she was on the podcast episode, what was it, 34? It was episode
34. Okay.
So check her out on Fire to Inspire the podcast.
Yes.
She is there talking about her whole, we were talking about public relations. Everything about being
PR.
A publicist. Mm-hmm. And again, she's the founder of Be The Buzz PR. Her company is located right here in Atlanta.
Mm-hmm.
And her focus is on public relations, branding, marketing, and event management. They're designed to work with brands in lifestyle, beauty, community relations, and entertainment.
Yeah.
So we just want to know more about the business, but let's talk networking, the power of networking, okay?
Yeah.
And so this event is all about that.
Mm-hmm.
But we want to do it non-traditionally, like you just said.
Right.
And we don't want to give too much, but let's talk about networking. Networking is tremendous power.
Mm-hmm.
Almost every success you have in life and business is about being the right person in the right room with the right network.
Mm-hmm.
You didn't know the right person that couldn't make things happen, but everything is related to networking. So your network is everyone, everybody that you meet. Face-to-face interactions, it doesn't matter who you meet.
Yeah.
You've got to make sure that any networking event that you go to, you make it work for you,
right.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
So let's elaborate on that. Like, how can we network and work the room?
So your whole point is you want to maximize on every effort and maximize on all opportunities. I think the problem that people go in is that they have a gimme mentality.
Yes.
And so the way I said, okay, the way I want to operate different things with, I guess, with my event is let's go and find maybe a person that you're not even looking for. And we've created different, you know, maybe games or different sessions to where through conversation, you can find out like, huh, I know a person that knows the person that can help you get to where you got to get to.
Right.
Oh, okay. So don't come in with a gimme mentality. You know, just go and try to find out about the other person and see, you know, how you may can be a benefit to them.
Because
what I find out in networking is that I can pull up my Rolodex or whatever, and I may have something that I can help them. It's not always about what someone can give you. And I think that's the problem nowadays
is
that we always want, but we don't want to give back. But,
and that's the thing. And that is the thing. Yeah. That is one of the biggest networking mistakes people make mm-hmm. is jumping the gun and asking for favors all earlier on. Mm-hmm. And the cardinal key to success is giving before you can receive.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
so how can we do that? The relation that you have, the relationships that you have with your network, mm-hmm. it's important that you don't, you are not prejudiced right. to who's in the room. A lot of times right. we like, oh, she ain't dressed this way. Oh, she ain't snatched. Her hair ain't this way. Her nails ain't done.
Yeah.
But she might have way more money in the bank than you do, boo.
Maybe the smartest thing.
It's really
in the room. And right. you're going to talk about this girl because she looked like, you know.
And sometimes I come out like that, but you don't know who
I know. You don't know who
you know. You do not know who's in the room with you.
That's true. Work
so you got to be relevant.
Yes.
Do things for your network. Deliver the things that you promise. So when you're giving, because a lot of times we want to come in here and say, you know what? I want you to put me on.
Yeah.
And you know what? I do not knock that.
Yeah.
But the thing is how, like you said, the keywords, how are you beneficial to the other person? And it's like, oh, you got to do something for something. No, but sometimes a mm-hmm. heart of service will take you a long way. Right?
Thank you. Thank right? you. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. You, you lose your credibility when you come with me with your gimme, gimme. It makes me see, it makes me feel like this is a cheap relationship. Like, it's just like, it's all about you.
Yeah.
You know?
I know.
So.
And so now we're going to talk about when you're networking, just mm-hmm. don't collect the business cards.
Yes.
We almost in 2020, babe. We have not, I don't even care I don't really care around my business cards. Do you? Yeah. I mean, I
carry them.
But I don't use
it. It depends on what network, what particular business you're
okay.
in.
Yeah,
you
you're
know,
right.
Because there's some businesses, you have a card, you have a card. So whereas in the entertainment or in this fast-paced industry that me and you are in, it's like, what's your social media?
Exactly.
So that is our business card. That's our resume.
It is.
But in other social networkings I've been to, it's like, where's your business card? And when you don't have a business card, sometimes kind of like,
you look
know.
Crazy.
So it's I don't want the people to forget like your business card. Don't let us tell you you should have a business.
you should, but I don't think you need to collect.
Oh, yeah, do not.
And that's the thing. In the game of networking, you're going for quality, not mm-hmm. quantity. So we have to remember that.
Yeah.
So it's simply focusing on beefing up your Rolodex. But if you're doing that, it will backfire on you.
It will backfire. But, you know, like you're collecting all these cards, but are you following up? What's your follow-up game?
Oh, come on. That was next, honey.
You need to follow up. You need, in 24 hours, you need to send out an email. Not 48, not 72. Get right on their brain. If you can do it first thing in the morning, go ahead and add them to your mailing list. Do something. Go to their DMs. You can call them if you're that bold, whatever.
I'm bold.
I saw you last night. You know, that's the problem. We collect all these cards and we don't follow up.
And we don't do anything. And you have all this chemistry that you make with people. Sometimes you connect really well and you have these great ideas. Sometimes you're having conversations that are worth $1 million for you. And what are we doing? We're dropping the ball.
That's it.
We're not following up, and that is some power. A follow up.
That's
within it. 48. I believe in that. 48 hours. I believe.
Yeah,
in that.
That's the max I'm gonna give you. 48.
That I'm telling you, because after
hours.
Clicking with a powerful new connection, too many people again. I said drop the ball.
Mm-hmm.
Failing to check in.
Yeah,
that's not good.
Yeah,
you know. Yeah. So I want to also pinpoint that if we're actually in the room. Mm-hmm. Networking, instead of getting business cards, write down each person. Like, if you get business cards.
Yeah.
Because you can get so many. I don't want you to collect 1,000 of them just in the room. Give me that. Just mm-hmm. to be kind of, you know, strategic.
Remember their
Do
name.
You agree?
Yeah, remember their name.
Yes.
That's important. I think you can lose someone when you try to approach them again, or even a cop has someone to try to call me or email me, had my name wrong. I'm not Sasha.
Who is Sasha?
Did you get my card, ma'am? Did you get my social media?
Right.
Because my name is Sarah.
You gotta know your stuff.
So then that kind of just like, are you taking yourself serious? Because you just came, you know what I'm saying? So you gotta be very strategic. You know
you
what
really
I'm saying?
Do.
That's
you
the problem. And we've gotten so, I think our culture's gotten a little bit of lazy when we do, you know.
Yes.
I hate to say a little bit, you know, that's being nice.
I would wouldn't say lazy. I would say greedy.
Greedy.
Because that's why I said, when you're in the room and you're trying to collect business cards, okay, baby, I'm not in here trying to, let me get your car. Why am I trying to connect with you? That's the question that you have to ask. Like, why do I
they
want
may not
you
even be the right
in
person.
My phone?
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
They I'm married, right. So I'm not going to be getting everybody the man
car. Car.
So it's got to be a reason why you can be a powerful connection in my own network. So you have to know your own needs.
You
have before
goals.
You. You get what I'm saying?
You need to know your own goals. So if you're lacking something.
Right.
So I think networking goes with different personalities. So you have some personalities, they just want to network because they just don't have any friends. They've moved to a new city.
Yeah.
They don't have any friends. So they're really probably just trying to really create friendships or relationships.
Absolutely.
Or like have someone to go out to dinner with on Friday night. If that's your goal, come out. Absolutely.
Right.
Definitely. If you have something that you're just like, you know, I need some help with my finance or I need some help with like, you know, collaborations because I've been doing it everything on my own, you may find a partner with you. A partner will probably be in that room. So I feel like people come to events and they don't have any goals.
No
they just
goals.
Come just to be just socialite or to post to social media or I was here. But like, come on now, like have some goals.
have some goals. And also let's talk about the confidence level. Like how can one person, just say you have an introverted person, and you got the extrovert. I mean, they're going to work their bubble. They're going to, you're going to always,
work the room.
Right. You're going to always see the loudest person, hello, in the room. They're using their body language. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about it. Like, how should they use their confidence in a room?
The best advice I would say for those that are scared, introvert, is to kind of practice at home. Practice on talking about, I've seen introverts are so smart at what they do, but they don't know how to communicate it to someone else. And I find out later through digging, because I'm an extrovert, I find out, wow, you are very educated. Like, you know what you're talking
about.
I have no idea what this is you're talking about, but it sounds like you are... I think practice makes perfect. Just kind of just go rehearse, you know? And you know what I like? I like for you to tell me, you know, I'm so sorry. I'm really an introvert, so it's kind of hard for me to communicate. I'm that type of person. Tell me. I'm like, that's okay.
Yeah.
I can walk you through or like, because I'm interested in knowing, you know, what you do, who you are. My best advice is practice. Try with your friends if you can. In the mirror. Going back to like
get
the basics.
In the mirror. It's
and
the best
see
thing.
How you talk.
I love the mirror.
You know, calculate your ums, because I had someone to calculate my ums one time.
Yes,
and I'm like, okay, thank you for telling me that. Thank you for telling me that. Really just practice at home. When you're an introvert, it's kind of hard, you know. Sometimes you need to connect with an extrovert that can kind of
bring you out. Come
and
on
get
out
comfortable.
With us. We gonna
so
get
it's
you.
Really no secret sauce. It's no secret sauce.
Right.
But I think introverts, I just wish they'll just come on out and connect with someone that's
they
really...
They have to dig deeper.
They have to dig deeper.
And you have to use other attributes that you can use to play off of. If you're an introvert, you can use your body language. You know, I don't like to say fake it till you make it type thing.
Yeah.
But the outer surface is the best thing that you can use. Okay, it's all about your appearance. Let's talk about it. I mean, sometimes we get lazy and we're going to these events and we don't know. It might be Obama over there. We might be seeing Michelle Obama, Oprah, whoever in the room, and you look like you just got out of bed. And you didn't try your very best and they didn't take you seriously. A lot of people look at the appearance, which is not, you know, that's not the best thing. But to really look a certain way really takes you a long way.
Yeah.
So that can help an
that's
introvert.
That's a factor.
Yeah.
That's a factor. Unfortunately, people do judge you off your first. The first impressions are everything.
Absolutely.
So, you know, I feel like that's why I call them the underdogs are overlooked. They're the most talented, probably the one in the room. They're not the most flashiest or they don't have the most name brands, but they don't know how to dress. So it's a lack of education there maybe, or they don't know, or maybe they don't have. That's another thing.
Exactly,
maybe they don't have. I'm just a person about Googling and kind of researching, but some people don't even think about that.
Yeah.
So me, everyone's not like me, but I like to go to those that probably are not the most presented in the best way, because they are a hidden gem. You never know. I found some hidden gems. But everyone's not like me. You know, there's some mean girls out here.
It is. And, you know, I'm not even really focusing on what you wear. It's about just your, you know, your
presence.
your presence and your hygiene, like smelling well. Like, I'm telling y'all, it's a,
that's a whole topic.
It's a real thing out here. When you're networking with people, people are looking at what you are bringing to your appearance. I mean, and we just got to figure that out.
They may want to work with you.
Yes,
and
exactly.
So they want, if you come to this event, they're like, well, maybe you might come to that event with them or whatever. So that's,
but that's a small little, you know, little key for introverted people.
Yeah.
But also get out. Practice makes perfect. Get out there. Mm-hmm. I mean, I don't care if you're trying to date, like you said, socialize. If you don't ever get out of the house, nobody will ever see you. Nobody will ever connect with you. You will never have that powerful connection.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So now we're going to move on to expanding your network. But we're going to go ahead and take a break. All right? We'll be right back. And remember, you are a boss, baby.
Hey.
Days, pay day, swipe my card, then I do the lay day. You're talking to a late day. I want a Kanye, yay, not a Ray J. So that's a no-no. I'ma make back and use a Volvo. This convo be like Dre, ay, I already know what you're trying to say.
We are back, my fiery family, and we are talking about the power of networking. I'm here with Sarah Busby, all right, and we're going to continue the conversation, and I want to definitely talk about expanding your network and deepening your network pool. So we tend to hang out with the people like ourselves. And we, you know, like the same gender, ethnicity, academic background, it doesn't matter. But diversity is key to growing a strong personal network. What do you think about that?
100%.
I mean,
I wouldn't be where I am if I hadn't expanded my network.
Right.
Seriously.
Absolutely. So seeking relationship with totally different people who can introduce you to brand new social clusters not only will gain access to potentially influential individuals whom you'd otherwise might not ever meet,
right,
but you'll stand out from the rest. Mm-hmm. So do not miss out on, you know, I know you're used to hanging out with the same, you know, crowd.
Yeah.
You know, but sometimes stepping out of the box can really help you.
Yeah.
I'm just saying.
Yeah.
Even in your dating relationship. Hello.
Yeah. It bring variety to yourself. Bring variety to your business. just, you know, that's, to me, that's another like a branding thing as well.
Absolutely.
It's really expanding your network. Network with people who you wouldn't even have thought that, you know, would look like they would, I guess, go with your brand or go with who you are. Cause I've noticed the ones that you would probably think like, oh, you know, she doesn't, you know, they have sent some business, and not even business, just like, if I need the smallest thing, like, hey, right, can you bring something over here to, from, you know, Lithonia or something? Yeah, I got you.
And yeah.
You know, so you just never know. I think that's a problem, too. We just try to network with people or be in business with people that look like us.
Yes.
And that's not fair.
That's not fair. I mean, and that's, again, if you're introverted or whoever, if you're so used to talking to one gender or one race or something like that, you're really not going
it's
to
clicky.
Expand. Like, you just, I'm telling you. The person that you're sitting next to, a lot of times we're at these events and we're sitting next to people and we're not even saying, hey, my name is Angel, Angel Yasmeen, okay? Angel Yasmeen, and you're not shaking hands with the person that you're sitting next to. What are you there for?
Be like
What's
you are
point?
In church when they tell you to, you know, turn to your left.
Turn to your neighbor.
You don't know that person at all. Well, at least I don't, unless I'm, you know, sitting by my friends.
Mm-hmm.
But if you just, you know, randomly, you don't know that person.
Right.
Lean to your left. Go to your right. Hold their hand.
Right. Speak to your neighbor.
Speak to your
Get
neighbor.
Get to know your neighbor.
Get to pray for them, you know.
You know. So. I know y'all don't like to do that in church, but you need to do that at the end.
I know, because they'll be kind of, the pastor be kind of doing it too. I'd be like, dang,
I don't want to talk to my neighbor no more.
Yeah, I didn't pray for him already, pastor. That's enough. Thank you.
Right. But look, the most successful people in the world realize that the more diverse their network is, the more powerful it becomes.
Yes.
And I promise you, I don't play. Like, I don't mind meeting people from all different cultures. I mean, Atlanta, especially, is a melting pot. I mean, it's so diverse. I mean, there's no reason why we shouldn't go out there and knock on doors that could potentially be the next connect that can take you to that next level.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I don't know if you ever figured this out, but when you network, have you ever really found someone that's really from Atlanta, though? Like, I met a lot of... No.
They're not.
They're from, like, oh, I'm from D.C., or I'm from Miami,
Jersey.
I'm from Jersey.
Right.
Look at all those. Look at your reach. Your reach is, like, everywhere. You never know who they know.
And everybody knows somebody.
Wow, yes.
I'm telling you.
I feel like Atlanta is, like, full circle. Oh,
it
you
is.
Know that person? Oh, you know... Oh, I follow them. Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And so... I don't want us to minimize.
Mm-hmm.
We have to maximize in the room.
Literally.
Because if you're coming to the event on Sunday, if I catch you sitting there by yourself, I'm like, girl, get
oh,
up.
Oh, there are no seats. There are no seats for you to sit.
Oh, okay.
So introverts, I'm letting you know now. You will not find a corner to sit down and eat and drink your mimosa.
Ooh.
You will, oh, yeah, I forgot. Mimosas, guys. You know, it's on a Sunday. I couldn't forget that. Yeah, so there are literally no opportunities. So, if you just really came, like, oh, I need a corner, there's literally no chairs.
Really?
No chairs will be out until the panel.
Well, make sure you wear your comfortable shoes.
Comfortable shoes, guys. Like,
I'm glad you told me that, honey.
Oh, yeah. But lately, I've been just, it's hard to find chairs. Like, there's not a lot of chairs. Some people take those away.
Right.
I'm so serious.
Yeah.
And I'd be like, dang, I kind of want to sit down. My feet hurting.
Yeah. But that's when you need to be working the room.
Working the room.
And shaking hands with everybody in the room. Because tell them, like, what kind of people are going to be on your panel?
So everyone on the panel is entrepreneurs.
Mm-hmm.
They are in media.
Okay.
So, and, you know, I really want to tap into the industry, tap into monetizing and maximizing on different opportunities when you're
Absolutely.
In media. And even in 2019, I feel like a lot of people got a lot of little side hustles, side business or side things they want to get into. Cause let's just be real. You just can't make one income nowadays.
Nope.
You gotta let that pond just be flowing with different money and opportunity. Ching, ching, ching. And you know, Cash App, Venmo, PayPal needs to be just ringing off the hook like jingle bells.
Mm-hmm.
And so, I mean, so we're talking, I told everybody, I said, let's be very transparent. Let's give people actual resources and steps the right way. Let's not get all, you know, crazy. But but yeah, so everyone on the panel is in media. So the idea was to connect us with power partners. So our power partners, as you know, since we're always on the go, is, you know, makeup, hair, designer, stylist, videographers, photographers. It's so hard because it's so many different events and opportunities for the video, especially your creatives, that you probably need somebody else.
Right.
And I've seen some hidden talent that I would love to be in the room. So if you're in the creative field, I don't care if you're a realtor, you're a broker, you're in insurance, we need that. I know some entrepreneurs that don't have their business in line. They ain't even got an LLC. I'm just saying, you know, come on in the room,
right.
Get them situated, because they don't need to be run. We need to learn how to do things the right way. That's
the
not,
right way.
I don't want us to half step. You know, it's October. What's today? October. I forgot the date. The 17th.
Yeah, I can't keep up.
Honey. October the 17th. So we're in the fourth quarter to get everything right. Ask Santa Claus to give you the money to get this LLC, to get this trademark.
To hire a publicist.
Hallelujah. Get that branding. Because I look at your brand. Please,
yes.
Get your marketing right. Get that logo right. Get it now. Get that business right. So when January the 1st comes, you ready to take 2020 like by storm because you're prepared. So that is the whole point. I'm going to go to different people like, hey, what do you do? Oh, okay. Well, how are you trying to get there? Okay, well, let's see how we can help you get there. I know someone, blah, blah, you know.
And you have a networking group now, right?
Yeah, I'm in a networking group. I'm actually the president. I'm a networking group. I actually went in there shy. I don't know what. Couldn't talk. I was so... See, and my background's in journalism. You would have thought I would have just...
Same here.
I was so scared. I thought, they don't like me. And less than 2 years later, I was voted to be around the group.
I am so proud of you.
Yeah.
But it's those gems that are in the inside of it. It's like a hidden treasure.
Yeah.
A lot of people do not know how to break past their fears. And I was one of them. I'm still breaking past.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
People that are entrepreneurs, it's not easy for them to just say, okay, I wake up and be great today. And you know, like, you can't just wake up and say, I'm gonna be great today. Like, you've got to really pep talk yourself.
You
do. I'm about to get on this live, man.
I'm about to go crazy. Because if you do it, you know, because by 2 o'clock, that email probably had you cussing at the email, like, that you'll get. And you'd be like,
right.
Now look, I told you, I done already explained this to you. And then that whole motivation series that you had this morning, it's gone.
It's gone.
I done already been cussed about 5, 10 times by 5 o'clock.
You gotta keep that engine going, girl.
I'm gonna keep it real. But that's how it is, you know, because you're dealing with, because some other entrepreneurs don't know how to do business or they don't read. So, you know, you have to deal with that. But I think the biggest part with me is that with networking is that I build relationships outside of the networking. So I'm like, hey, let's go out to lunch. Let's get coffee. Let's hang out. That right there. That'll take you a long way.
I'm so
I know it's hard.
I'm really an omnivert. I'm both.
Okay.
I'm introverted because I love my hometown. I love to be at home.
I get it.
And I just like to be snuggled. And
I like to be snuggled by myself. You know, we over here.
I'm not even snuggled with my man. I'm just saying by myself,
just in your own world. Yeah.
Because again, as an entrepreneur, you've got to understand that self-care is the best health care.
You gotta wind down.
You cannot give yourself away to every and any body, but that's a whole nother podcast.
Yeah, I'm gonna give y'all a tip for next year. I'm like literally like I'm not going to everything. I already said. I'm kind of working on
that's
it now,
true.
But I'm not going to everything. I'm like no.
You know what, Sarah? That's a good thing that you said that.
Mm-hmm.
Again, it's just like collecting the business cards. I found, you know, starting Fire to Inspire. Everybody was grabbing. Angel, come here. Angel, come there. And I'm like, whoa, pump the brakes.
We're going to talk about it. Yeah, we
and
definitely.
And I'm a, you know, well, no. Yeah. I used to be a people pleaser.
Yeah.
We've shot that out the door because we want to be strategic in 2020.
Yeah.
What's our 2020 vision? We are going to be strategic.
Yeah.
We are going to know our goals.
Goals.
And we're going to have quarterly goals.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to have monthly, you know, whatever, and we're going to have our yearly goals, and then you're going to have your 3 to 5 year goals and maybe 10.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing about it is I'm not just going to just be going to any and everything.
Yeah, you are who you are. You are who you associate yourself with.
Absolutely.
You know, our parents told
That's
us that.
True.
And it's true. I look at that even in business, and it's been brought to my attention too, like, oh, I didn't know you know, such and such. So you have to be very, very careful.
Right.
Go back to being strategic. If that person, your ideal client, customer, power partner, is not going to be in the room, you know, kind of think about that if you want to make that effort to get ready, fight traffic here in Atlanta, and go to that.
Yeah.
So, that's important.
Well, okay, so let's go here. I really hate I have to go here.
You get on my nerves, and I can't. Wait, what you mean?
Wait a minute. We'll wait for that one to come back. We're going to finesse the room, though. We'll be right back.
Yes.
All right. What room?
Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond.
Fine light in the beautiful sea. I chose to be happy. You and I, you and I. We're like diamonds in the sky. You're a shooting star I see. A vision of ecstasy. When you hold me, I'm alive. We're like diamonds in the sky. I knew there would become one right away. Oh, right away. At first sight, I felt the energy of some rhythm. I saw the life inside.
So shine bright tonight. You and I were beautiful.
Like a diamond, shine bright like a diamond, shine bright like a diamond. So shine bright tonight, you and I. We're beautiful like diamonds in the sky. Eye to eye, so alive. We're beautiful like diamonds.
We are back in action with my girl, Sarah. What's up, what's up?
What's up? I'm here.
Look, we are talking about the network, the power of networking, and we're going to continue the conversation. But look, I really hate to say this, but I've experienced some things being here in Atlanta that we have to tackle right now, and we're going to do it right here on the show.
Okay.
Let's talk about bitches in business.
Ooh, did I say that? I'm so sorry. No.
I said the B word because y'all, the industry is full of itches. I'll say that for the rest of the show. Because okay. I know my mama. I love my mama. She's watching the show and I don't want her to be saying
that. She's
like, Angel, what you saying? But listen, itches in business. It's a real thing. It Let's is. Talk about it.
Well, you know, I don't really know how to tell them. I mean, what kind, you know, there's different itches.
okay, business.
There's
like
different
when you're networking.
When you're networking,
stuff.
You know, I wonder, I've seen a whole bunch of them. A lot of the itches and see, I'm messing up because I'm not
you
used to
do
saying
you.
It.
I just, I know my
itches in business. I feel like there's a sense of entitlement. Uh-huh. And what I don't like is a mean girl mentality. It's yes. as if you, like, you should be honored to be in the room with them.
Right.
And I'm like, hold up. Mm. I only go to the knees of the Father. We not, you know, and I think it's a matter of, like, back to, like, your sorority type of thing. Like, oh, you got to get me this. You got to do this for me to get to where I'm at or for me to even give you something that, you know, I think you need. Like, on an internship
Honey,
type of level.
Let's talk about how they don't want to speak.
They don't
want.
Oh, no. Definitely
let's
don't want to
do
speak. Okay, let's start there. Don't want to speak. Now, when you go up to them, they're like, okay. Okay.
And honey, look down on you. I'm like, baby, you don't know what God is doing over here. Don't look down
on
me.
But what kills me about them is that I be like, okay, they're like this. But like, Lord, how you be like blessing? Like, they be doing all this stuff. And they act this way.
Well, I wouldn't dare blame that on God.
I ain't blaming on him. But I'm just wondering. I be my feelings, though. I be like,
that's just them. And that's just their character. And you know, the devil blesses too now. Tell the truth.
Yeah.
Now
yeah.
we can say that. The devil blesses too. And they know how to get they know how to get
yeah.
theirs.
Yeah.
And we don't know what they're going
through. I feel
like
it's insecurity.
It's a lot of insecurity.
I feel like there's a lot of insecurities. Uh-huh. A lot of different things. I feel like if you broke them down and they had like a session, uh-huh. they would be like down to like a little baby.
Right.
I think it's a lot of insecurity. I think that boosts them up, makes them feel important because there's areas in their lives where they're not the dominant factor, or they're not the most important, you know,
right.
probably I've seen. But it can be very, you know, discouraging when you're networking, you're trying to connect with them. And maybe sometimes I've seen, or even me, I've kind of not idolized, but I've really looked up to them and like, oh my gosh,
right.
you know, social media is Jesus. It's like, you know, putting some over your eyes, like, because everything ain't what it's cracked up to be on social media.
Right.
So if
right.
you look at social media, you're like, oh my God, I really want to connect with them. And you finally build up the nerve and you go up to them and it's like,
they make you feel like $2.
Why are you?
Not even a dollar, just
not
a dime.
Not even maybe a penny.
Right.
Like, a nickel. I mean, it's just too much.
Yeah, I really think it's important that when you're working the room, because, again, we're talking about networking,
mm-hmm.
wherever that is. It could be business relationships, period,
yeah,
whatever. Don't matter. You could be at church. I don't care. At the grocery store. Again, I will say face-to-face interactions are important. But
yeah.
when you're meeting somebody in the room and you think that you're higher than someone, that why are you there? What's the point? Because if you cannot be reachable and also teachable, at the
yeah.
same time, because whoever approaches you, somebody can approach me, I'm always going to be smiling. I'm
right.
always going to be, you know, giving them my best face because
right.
that's how my heart is set up. But everybody's heart is not like that.
Mm-mm.
And I have recently ran into it, now that I'm in this industry, don't know if I really like it because it's a lot of mean people out there.
Mm-hmm.
It's a lot of mean people in business. And I'm like thinking to myself, okay, if I hire you and I'm paying you my hard-earned money,
yeah.
okay, first of all, Atlanta is not cheap. Photography, graphic designers, whoever. But you got to understand, we
yes.
live in a small world, okay? We
yeah.
live in a small world, and everybody that you meet in the industry will know you, okay?
Yes.
So you've got to be careful on how you treat people because I can say, you know
yeah.
what, Sarah, I was working
yeah.
with this photographer, and honey, I didn't like the way she was treating me. She treated
uh-huh.
me like crap.
Yeah.
She was talking to me any kind of way, and I was trying to work with her and be real nice with her.
Uh-huh.
And then what?
They'd be
and
like,
then what? And then, okay, so what's going to happen? The pictures look good. Somebody's
mm-hmm.
going to say, who did your pictures? I'm going to say, you know what? Don't use her. And
yeah.
my mouth could be just as powerful and shut the whole thing down for you in the city of Atlanta
yeah.
because of my mouth.
Yes.
You don't know who people
you
know. So that's why it's
a situation
important.
Like that. I was describing,
mm-hmm.
you know, so just like what you did.
Right.
And they called out a name. It was like, oh, was it such and such?
Ooh.
I was like, no. That right there, people got your
know.
Name in their mouth. If
mm-hmm.
they know who you are. And it's so small. And I came back a week later and found out, oh my God, I have met that woman. Like, and what did that tell me? Can't work with her. Gotta be careful because things come around full circle.
And you can be a good person in your craft, but ain't nobody fooling with you if you got an attitude.
You got an attitude.
And you just mad at the world. And again, I am not judging
customer service
because a lot of people are going through a lot of things when they come from a place of hurt.
Yeah.
But see, everybody's not big like me consciously.
Yeah.
Everybody's not thinking like that. They will cuss you out. Do you hear me? And not use you again and blackball you.
Blackball you in the city, and you
will not be usable. You could be the best person.
You could
be Picasso in the game, but ain't nobody gonna call you.
You gotta be careful.
That's it.
A lot of times, you know, you get blackballed because of bad business practices.
Right.
You know, it don't even have to be your customer service. It could just be a lack of just keeping a good, I don't know, just bad business.
Right.
Bad business, right. Really. I've heard some things, you know. I hope ain't nobody really out here talking about me, but hey, somebody could just say I didn't do something right and could talk about me. You know, you can't stop people
from talking
about you.
Yeah.
However, it's bad when your name is in someone's mouth and it's going around in a circle, and then I'm putting it together in full circle. I'm like, oh yeah, I know them. That you gotta be careful.
You have to
everything.
Be very
I've realized within the years I've been living here, everything does come back full circle.
And you gotta be careful on how you handle your business. Like you just said, it's not all about how you speak, and all this other stuff. It's really about how you treat other people in the room, because you never know. And then let's talk about people that are, you know, networking, but then they may be sleeping with people to get up there.
Gee,
we have to have that conversation.
We gotta
have
that.
To inspire. So we're here
to inspire you to be your best you. That's some people network and practice.
That's what they do.
I know what to do.
But the thing is, that word gets around too. You got to be careful.
Yes, child.
And I'm just saying, Atlanta's too small. You don't want to play like that. You don't want to play that big game because you don't want to get. You got quiet on me. I don't care.
Because I have seen. If I was to
Come
do
on,
like
let's
a,
talk about
a
it.
Scale, how many times I heard that is up there.
You don't want that name.
Getting where you gotta get.
Ooh.
To get what you gotta get. To get where you. It's like selling your.
It is selling yourself.
So you gotta be. You.
Ooh.
Go back
this
to goals.
Industry is
it go back. Let's go back to your goals. How bad? Okay. It's one thing. How bad do you want it? But do you want it that bad? Because it's going to come out. I don't care.
If
it could be 5 years. Like, it could be 10 years. Like, it could be when you are there. But that's when dirty laundry comes out.
Right.
So we just gotta be very careful.
But why are we talking about this, y'all? Why are we talking about this? I'm all about building character. Am I perfect? Hell no. I am far from perfect, but
at the same time,
in business, you got to be damn near perfect because you got to put on your perfect face. I'm just being honest. Because if you want to keep making money, it's all about building and monetizing, making passive income. And if you want to keep a good name, a clean name, be clean.
Yeah.
Do the thing clean. I don't know how else to express it. Now, I bring that up because I've seen a lot of it in the industry. And a lot of time, God will place you in rooms to observe, like Sarah Jake said, to observe the room
observe
the characters in the room. So therefore, you don't have to be like that.
You won't have to be like that. Give the alternative, you know, to a situation.
Uh-huh.
Be different.
Right.
You know, come. I encourage people that are listening to this, be different. Be who, you know.
Yeah, there you go.
Who, you know, be who, if you don't want to be like that mean girl, or you see a mean girl, somebody treated you that way, be different. Make sure that you set your business, because you are your business and you are your brand. Back to what I do.
Right.
You are your brand. So that's very important that you keep yourself accordingly. Because some people will, we ain't dealing with attitudes out here.
No.
Because that's why people are itches. Because of they were nice in the beginning. They were like doing stuff for free. They was going out their way. You know, you need me to pick you up from Washington, D.C.? I got to go to Alabama now tomorrow. But I'm going to go pick you up. Then I got to go to Jamaica. But
right.
I got you, girl.
I got you, girl. And then you can't pick up the phone and call them if you need them. Ooh, did I say that?
For the ones that are itches, I kind of understand a little bit probably why you are, because people
are
misuse
you.
They treated you wrong.
Mm-hmm.
They stole from you.
Yep.
And they probably defamed your character. They lied on you. So that's probably why you were it.
I know.
If I was to sit down with you and you told me, I'd be like, girl, boy, let's fight them together.
I'm telling
you. Let's do it together.
You got to know your value.
You got to know your value.
You got to know your value and how you set the standard and how you set your price tag.
Yes.
Is how you set your character. I believe in that. Yes. I mean, we have got to go back to the basics of just being kind and loving and wonderful people. But yeah, we don't know how to do that because we're so busy trying to be somebody. You know what I'm saying? Be somebody. And it's okay to be somebody.
Be somebody.
But be a light. Be the light. You know what I mean?
Your work is going
like,
to do.
It goes a long way.
Your work is your work and your character, your customer service, all that, that's going to play for you. That's
yes.
going to, people don't realize that. They feel like they got to do all this extra stuff. I promise you, you don't. I promise you, you don't. All that extra
right.
stuff, you know, you ain't got to be the most fashionable person in the room.
Right.
But your
you
character,
don't.
Your smile.
Will take you
Will take
there.
You places.
That's now, like I'm, one of the laws of of confidence. Your
yeah,
smile.
Your smile. Yeah,
you don't even have to say a word if you're smiling.
You could have broken glass teeth, but
right.
If,
you're so crazy. What?
But if you can, I mean, if you got the character to hold a conversation,
yes.
I don't remember them broken glass teeth, but I'm remember you having a conversation
your
with
personal.
Me. People be looking at all this like, oh, I got to look the certain way. I got you. It's other ways that you can really blossom and really show
absolutely.
Who you are. Okay,
ooh,
you probably
girl.
Just can't afford to fix your teeth, girl.
You
got,
look,
I got a gap.
I got
a gap. You know,
we gonna get that though. We get
one day I'm gonna get a bag. Like, you know,
we don't have to have the bag now. They have that little thing that you can put the little what's the little sliding what? Is
you
for your teeth.
I thought it
is it like
months.
Invisalign?
It's like but it's like the Smile Direct Club.
Yeah,
you
I
can
want
do that.
That. I already
yeah,
signed
you
up
that.
For it. I'm gonna get me.
Yeah,
some.
It's monthly, but it's good though. I thought about it too. I was like, that's another bill.
It's a bill. It's a bill. But
it
again,
bill.
It's something that I want to do. I mean,
but
it's
and
what
not
you
stuff between
do.
Like, okay, I'm known for the Gap. Should I close the Gap? Like a
it's
trademark.
So crazy.
But no, I look at that. I'm known for the Gap. So, but I've always wanted to close it. So that's what we're working on that. We'll see.
Okay, so let's talk about wait a minute, what time it is? It's 1:54.
Okay.
Okay, so let's talk about really quickly, is it okay to do stuff for free? Before we get off air. Cause
you want my honest opinion?
Be honest.
Yes.
Cause you've been in the game. I wanna
it
know.
It is. Okay, so this is what you should ask yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have experience?
There you go.
Do
there
you
go.
Have portfolio?
Yes.
Can you do something that would take a person that has, you know, more experience? Can you do it in an hour? Can you do it in 10 minutes?
Right.
Can you think? Can you do some critical thinking? Do you know how to put up a plan together in a crisis? Do you know how to do certain things?
Right.
Do you have a portfolio to show?
Do you
have you been in the rooms with certain people? Those type of things. You don't have any of those things, and I don't care, so I would say this, even if you have a portfolio, even if you've had that, sometimes there are goals, your goals should change constantly.
Absolutely.
And if your goals have changed,
absolutely.
And somebody gave you the opportunity to be in a room, you may have to do, you
come
know,
on.
Whatever, not get paid, but that's, you know you want to be, you got a goal, I haven't met a person that wouldn't do it.
And this is the thing, the reason why I asked that question, because again, I'm still fresh in the game.
Mm-hmm.
I'm fresh meat.
Yeah.
And people will come to you and say, hey, come on, let's do this. Put me on again. Let's say that. But the thing is, how is it beneficial? I want to go back to the heart.
Yeah.
That heart of service. Giving back. I'm telling you, when you're helping other people, you don't know who they know.
Yeah.
And you don't know who they people that they know. I'm
yeah.
just saying the connection is real.
Yeah.
So the reason why I brought that up, because even me, I have done things for free. In the beginning, but then it's going to come a time where it's time for you to phase on to the next level, and you got to know your price tag. But do not be afraid of that, because
yeah.
a lot of times we're afraid to even say our
but
prices.
Can I give you a secret, though? There's some well-established business owners that they'll never show it, they'll never say, but they do some barter.
Exactly.
They do some free
exactly.
stuff. So, y'all, I know y'all probably exactly. look at that. No, I ain't. What? I got to feed these kids. I got to do all this.
Don't be cocky.
You ain't nothing if you ain't got no relationship.
I'm
going to tell you that.
Come
you
on.
Ain't nothing. If you ain't got these folks' cell number, email, whatever, because some people don't even like to give the email because that's their way mm-hmm. of communicating too. If you don't have that, you got to think about it. You really got to think about this. Back to being strategic, back to goals. If you don't have that, then what
right.
do you have in business? You know, so that's important. So, yes, it is okay to do things for free. Start off, you know, doing stuff for free as you get to a certain point. Yes, know your price tag. And then, two, when you get to that certain level where you having a price tag, if you have to do something for free, get something. Let it make sense and get some in return.
There you go.
Get something in return. That's where the barter comes in, but a lot of people bartering.
Get out there. Get out there. Get known. Work with these people. Don't say no. And don't say no because you're afraid.
Yeah. Don't do it all the time, though. I'm not going to encourage you to barter all the time because Georgia Power doesn't have a, you know, it's, they want numerical. They don't want any alphabetical barter to pay them. So I'm not telling you guys. Let it make sense.
There you go. Don't stretch yourself too thin, because that's what happened. And then I also want you to I want you guys to realize, when you're an entrepreneur, allow yourself to make mistakes.
Oh yeah.
That's a big one. Allow yourself to fail. Because I wasn't always easy. It wasn't always easy for me to get on and go live. Like, today is like, okay, we're feeling ourselves. We're doing a little better. I'm just saying, you've got to give yourself some time. Mm-hmm. Practice makes perfect.
Yes.
We're going to talk about that over and over. Get out there. Yeah. Get to know some people. Do not be prejudiced. Get to know everybody in the room.
That's a good one.
And I want to ask the last question. What ignites you to do what you love on a daily basis?
Oh, man. I know there's a purpose. I know I have a purpose, and I can't stop. Because if I do something different, I'm going to be miserable. So that's what pushed me. I'm like, okay, it's something at the end of the tunnel. Because if I do something else, I'm going to be miserable. So that's what ignites me now.
Well, thank you so much, Sarah. I've had so much fun on this show because you're my girl, and I cannot wait for the Mix and Buzz on Sunday.
I'm excited. Y'all come gland up now. Look, I got to say that. Please dress nice and accordingly.
I know.
I'm telling you that now.
We want to dress up.
You follow my page on Be The Buzz PR. You'll see I got some examples of attire.
You know, sometimes I just love a reason to dress up. You know,
mamas, come out. Like, go to Target. Go somewhere. Walmart. The Walmart fashion came up. Y'all be doing Walmart. Walmart fashion has came up. Seriously.
I don't fool with it, but I just like Target, you know.
Target has came up. You know, come on now.
Not too good.
This is your opportunity. You got 4 hours to be cute. You may find your boo in there.
Right.
Hopefully, you know, not over me. But, you know, that's neither here or there.
We're going to find you.
Because, honey, lately, it's like, who sent you, sir? Where did you come from?
It's so crazy. Yeah, so we're going to be mixing, and we're going to figure out everything about what the buzz is going to be out on Sunday. So tell them how they can get the tickets.
Okay, so you need to be able to follow my page, my most latest post. Not the most latest post, but the post before that. I need you to screenshot that, put it on your story, DM me. I'm giving away two tickets. So go to my page, the post before, or the flyer, repost it on your story, and DM me. The first two people get a free ticket, okay?
Yay.
That's it.
Awesome. Well, you guys, make sure you told them where to follow you, right?
B-T-H-E-B-U-Z-Z-P-R. Be The Buzz PR.
Y'all got that? Be The Buzz PR. Find your girl right there. Thank you, everyone, for joining this party with a purpose. All right, I'll catch you next week. It's getting real hot up in here because I'm so fired up. Your next chapter in life. All right, it's getting real hot up in here. Let's fire away. IBNX Radio.